more of those under 2 minute and sports today.
Keep God first.
Watch me on entertainment and sports today.
Stay tuned for entertainment and sports today.
A big winner in the chat.
My name is John Korir. I'm from Kenya. Entertainment today.
Hello, this is Steve Taylor for Entertainment and Sports Today, real live from Century City at the finish line on Century Proc Bridge. You probably can't tell from this direction, but this is the same bridge used in the Planet of the Apes movie series, if you remember, way back in the 60s and the early 70s. The reason they used this bridge at the time, Century City was considered a most
looking city in the world.
So they used that to show the future of the Planet of the Apes. Anyway, Century Park is where they're going to be celebrating later on, and the finish line is right underneath us here. This is a Century Park bridge. The athletes will be coming in. And already right now, you see some of the setup over here. On the right side, on the left side, they got the stands of people that have been waiting here for a long time to get a good seat. And over there, see, that's the audience right there. They have the LA Laker girls, the cheerleaders, that'll be performing for us, scheduled for the finish line. They have about every 2 miles, they got major international talent, live bands, live music that's playing here for the marathon, about every 2 miles. And then the runners finish here, and then this is where they have some celebrity performances, music, and the Laker girls. We'll be showing you as much as we can and be talking to the winners later here in Century City. So stay tuned as we await the elite men's runners and the women. We're not sure yet, but it's the men are catching up to the women who will be given a lead. That's part of the challenge here for a big prize. So stay tuned as we are at the finish line here.
And it looks like it's going to be a woman winning the LA Marathon Challenge, with the women's gold medal being given to Kenyan's Delvine Meringer, holding off her countryman John Korir, the men's gold medal winner, for back-to-back wins.
Oh, great way to have it. It's a back-to-back winner. Oh, all right.
And it's amazing, with the 16-second lead over the men, Delvine's gonna win it. Here she is crossing the finish line with John catching up, but he's going to win back-to-back marathons year after year. Here she is, incredible race here, Tour de Vine.
Back-to-back winner. He won last year's marathon. Last year's only 24 years old. He wins it now back-to-back. And the fast time is under 210. 209. And our PR guy here giving the winner a back-to-back winner here. Doesn't happen at all. Be in shape to win the marathon 2 years in a row on the same course. With all the pennies there to compete against, it's pretty good. There he is with his country flag holding up for everybody there. And Richard, of course, our cameraman, sitting in the close right.
And coming up in second place is John's countryman from Kenya, Edwin Kamutai, who will win the men's silver medal. Here he is crossing the finish line. Unbelievable, Kenyans back-to-back, gold and silver, in a time of 2:10:43. Way to go, Kenya. An interesting story about John being only 25 years old. John won this marathon now 2 years in a row, being only the sixth person to do that in the history of the marathon. And one of those six people happens to be his big brother, Wesley Korir. By amazing coincidence, Wesley was sponsored by the Kenyan American Running Club, whom the director and sponsor, Scott Robinson, was my on-air reporter driving the lead marathon photo truck for two marathons that Wesley won in 2009 and 2010. Wesley won the 2009 LA Marathon in a time of 2:08:24, 13 years ago. With the head of the Kenyan American Running Club, Scott Robinson, by my side, the LA mayor of the time, Antonio Villaraigosa, welcomed Entertainment and Sports Today up on stage after the race and thanked us for covering the big race. When I interviewed John, he told me he trained 100 miles for this race, which is what gave him the confidence to win this race again. And here he is with his countrymen who got the silver medal. So here they are, gold and silver for Kenya. And the women also winning the gold and silver for Kenya. Unbelievable. What a great showing by Kenya. Stay tuned for more. It was an exciting and fast race today at this marathon. Here you're looking at the silver medalist for the women, for Kenya. Her second time in a row that she got the silver medal, twice in a row, Antonio Kawambi, in a great time of 2:30:13. What a great finish for the Kenyans. First and second with the women. Unbelievable. And they also did the same in the men's. First and second for Kenya in the men's. And Ethiopia had an incredible, only second to the Kenyans. Ethiopia had a great finish. Here's you looking at the bronze medal winner, Berhanu Bekele Berga, winning the bronze for Ethiopia in 2:15:10. Here's a group shot of them, as you see, with their coach over there. They're very proud. And here's the first American finisher, Tyler McCandless, who finished fourth in 2:15:18. A great finish for America. He'll be going to the Olympic Games. He qualifies for this race here. It's an incredible showing here by Kenyans, of course, first and second in the men's and women's division, and Ethiopia getting in both the men's and women's division a third place winner. And then, of course, the Americans getting a fourth place finish with the men. And then in the women's, the first American finish fifth place in 2:35:06. That was Amanda Phillips. So these both, they will both be going to the Olympic Games representing the United States of America. Stay tuned for more.
And here we are with the women's winners right there below us, as you can see. They're posing with us. And the top American there with the flag. He's there. There he is. He's looking up at us here on the photo bridge, posing with the American flag, the top American finisher. We want to give a special thanks to Dan there, the guy in the blue cap and the blue sweatshirt, who's bringing all these elite athletes to us to pose for some pictures after they've been running a long, long race. They're dead tired, exhausted, but they have just enough energy for us to pose for some more photos. And here we are with a top American woman here. That's great to see an American woman in the top, I think the top five or so, because usually they're not in the, anywhere close. That's good to see that. Same thing for the men. Usually it's the Kenyans that have like the all every spot's taken. But it's good to see some Americans in the top 10. This woman, I think, is about fifth place or so, number 110. And now she'll be posing for us up here on the photo bridge.
Mark Harper!
Hey!
Hey! Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Jolene Warren, Savannah McMichael, Elias Carrillo, Yvonne Dominguez, Mark Kralik, Donald.
And right after the finish on Avenue of the Stars in Century City, right by the Century City Bridge, we walked over from that finish line to the Kraft Restaurant where they have the VIP room. It's a beautiful restaurant overlooking all of Century City Park. And in there, we got a chance to talk to a lot of the athletes and interview them. They were both the gold, silver, and bronze medal winners for the men and the women. Most of them from Kenya and a couple from Ethiopia and some from China. We saw up to two. It was a great experience. And here you can see a beautiful Century Park. A lot of room there to party. A lot of the athletes, they were drinking beer. It was a big beer garden experience there with live entertainment and band and everything. Well, it was music, drinks, and a good time to celebrate in the after party after a great race. Stay tuned.
Very good point. I mean,
entertainment and sports today.